गुड आफ्टरनून किड्स. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी लर्न अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ फंक्शनल री एजुकेशन, इट्स इम्पोर्टेंस एंड यूजेस ऑफ सर्टन पोजिशंस एंड मैट एक्टिविटीज. टूडे वी विल बी लर्निंग द टॉपिक्स अहेड वेयर वी विल बी इंक्लूडिंग वेरियस पोजिशन टू मेक पेशेंट इंडिपेंडेंट from a bedridden position. First, from supine rolling to side lying to forearm supported side lying. Next position the patient can assume is sitting on the side of bed or mat where the patient's legs are hanging over the edge of the bed or mat. The patient can come to sit from supine to rolling to side lying to forearm supported side lying, and then he or she can push the body upwards by doing elbow extension. Legs are lifted and swung over the bed. When the patient is having hemiplegia or hemiparesis and is not able to lift and move both the limbs, one limb which is affected or weak or paralyzed, that can be crossed over the normal or strong limb which will support the paralyzed limb. In swinging, the body pivots over the one buttock which is bearing more weight, and it reaches a position of equal weight bearing when the patient comes to sitting position with both the legs hanging over the edge. Purposes and uses of sitting are initially, when the person starts with supported sitting, it can be progressed gradually to without support, where the muscles of trunk, neck are required to work against gravity. Second, righting and equilibrium reactions can be trained by pushing off the patient towards the weak side, thereby strengthening the righting and equilibrium reactions or balance training. These kind of pushing maneuvers are also known as perturbations, which you might have learned during the balance training. It is a position which is preliminary to standing and moving for dressing and toilet activities. In this kind of position, the arms of the patient are free so that the patient can do many activities at home, at work, or for recreation, such as playing chess or working on a laptop. So this makes patient independent in certain level of activities. Next is hitching and hiking. Once the patient is able to sit in the position of long sitting where the legs are extended straight on the mat, or in high sitting where the limbs are hanging over the edge of the bed or mat, next level of transition or ambulation is hitching and hiking. Here the patient uses blocks, sandbox bags, or short crutches. So initial phase where there is need to train the person for weight bearing, we can use this kind of supportive equipments. Once the patient is able to lift the weight over this kind of support and support is secured enough, the weight is shifted through arms, through the support, to the surface, and there is lifting of pelvis. So the buttocks are off the ground or off the surface, and the buttocks can be moved from one place to another. It can be in forward or backward direction or in the sideways direction. In these images, hitching and hiking are shown. Hitching is lifting the body. Hiking is shifting the body. Progression can be done in the stages where hands and buttocks are moved alternately so that it simulates walking pattern. Purposes and uses: it is an important as a primary training for transfers for wheelchair patients, so the patient can learn to move from bed to chair or from chair to the bed in return. Next, we will be learning various activities for training of movement and stability at floor level. It is important to train the patient to learn to get down, and practicing moving from one place or position to another. So by this training we can build good strength, coordination, endurance and confidence. It can be taught as home program for suitable individuals or as a group therapy for patients who are having similar kind of traits or characteristics. It should be modified as per the patient's need, especially for the patients who are unable to do activities in specific prescribed manner. Movement and stability at floor level can be according to the patient's level of independence. For patients who are able to stand with support, coming down to sitting is easier. The person can turn and face the bed or chair. Then he or she can lean forward on hands and provide support through those weight-bearing hands. Gradually, he will get into the kneeling position, and one hand is used for support away from the body in this kneeling position. And from kneeling down, the person can come to side sit. Then he can pivot the buttocks and extend both the legs to come into long sitting position. Other than that, the person can transfer from higher level chair or stool to lower level chair or stool or up to the floor. It is useful for the patients who are not able to stand but can sit on a higher surface. We need to arrange stools or boxes of different height so that a kind of shallow steps are designed. As you can see in the image, then person goes into hitching and hiking sideways from higher to lower surfaces. It is specifically useful for bilateral amputees. Lower limbs are affected so that the person can lift the body through the upper limbs and shift downwards toward the surface or floor. The person who are not able to sit erect without support can come to mat or bed from higher level mat or bed by rolling from supine to prone. Then gradually the person pivots until the feet hang over the edge of the bed, gradually slides backwards and bends knees until they are resting on the floor. From kneeling to kneel sitting to side sitting and then to long sitting. This is the sequence of coming to long sitting position. These are the different ways for different patients how he or she can come to mat. Now we will go into the activities which can be done, positions which can be attained on the mat.